switch in, kicked in, screwed in. Check the door. Yeah, looks fine. First thing we're gonna do is remove the door casing. Cut it with a utility knife. Here, pry it out, pull it out. Just remove this weather strip. Things like this. This is where it's screwed in at. About here and here. Another one here. Just gonna look at the jam up and down. See where you think the screws are. Gotta cut the caulk in here. Use the multi-tool over here. This wood in here. Dig all of this up. Put this in. There's no shims back there. Tap it. is the nails, this hole in there. Now I'm gonna cut it just a bit. I'm gonna cut it as close to this as possible. Okay, there's the jam. I have to pull it this way a little bit. Wiggle it out. Now that is out. Here's the new one, so obviously we're gonna cut that, this end off. Cut it. Piece of pressure here to go in here so we got something to screw to and put our threshold back. So see what's going to be. It's about 1%. I'm going to chip some of that out just so I can make it wider. Some pressure tree there. Put that one. 1 inch. Thickness varies, so however wide you need it to make it, that's how you make it. Same with the length. Now for this cut, I like to use a circular saw to port it so it won't kill my battery. You want to put the wood on somewhere solid. Make your first cut, stop, move the wood over, keep cutting. Okay, now put my wood in here, tap it down, and I'll put some tap cones in it. Put my tap cones in. I'm gonna use the Makita. This thing works great. Some 3-inch tap cone screws. Okay, so I wasn't really hitting nothing drilling this way, so I had to put it on an angle like this and go in that way. My angle. Screws in. We'll line it up better than that, but the two hands in place. Also the mark. Take it back out. Use some of this for under the threshold. Two screws. Put caulk here. Clean it up. And the threshold is done. Okay. So that's butted up against there, but you can move it back. There's no shims behind here yet. Now you want to check your door. Check the gap. You want about no more than 1/4 inch. Gap feels good all the way up. Except for here, it's kind of tight. So because you don't have the shim fit, can lightly tap it. Gotta get filled with caulk. Perfect. That's where you want to put the shims behind here. Put some tack, drill some tack cones back in the block, in the wood. Shims, cedar, regular wood shims. I put the fat in first. Shims in place to keep it from falling. Put 1 inch nails in. Put some tack cones in it. This and these. Let's use this countersink. This side of the wood, I can use 2 1/4. This side, use a longer one. And here, there, here, over here. Now, this check the door again. So I'm gonna do this. There. So set your marks. The door. Three square. Seven eighths. 1 inch paddle bit. Roll it out. Now also when you put in these screws, be careful so you don't hit. Stay away from the striker plate. Now you get a back set. Set it in place. Metal. Mark it out. Drill the hole. Chisel this out. Okay, then you put your striker plates on. Check the door. Catching. It's locked. This is not clicking. So that means it's not closing all the way. Somebody can push that open. So I'm gonna have to finish taking off this wood in here. That I'm gonna knock it out with this. You know, we got two cons. This is clamshell. See the shape. That's this one, clamshell, and this one's colonial. See, it has grooves in it. I cut the 45 first, then I cut the length. This and hit it with the hammer. Okay, I'm going to use the spackle again. Spackle these holes. Alright, so you see it's a little light at the bottom of the door. That's where these come in. Pull the sticker off. Stick it in just like that.
Leave the doors for Monday and have a half a day.